In this episode.
One job.
In this episode, we are talking about my favourite film ever, Ichi the Killer. Spoiler alert, it's not my favourite film ever. Fuck no. What else are we talking about?
You're so hilarious. We also talk about, there's also a chance to win a copy of the Antichrist soundtrack. And finally, we need to go home.
And the final thing that we're doing is we're going to change it up. And we're going to choose a film in a different way. And you are going to help us choose.
Yes, stay tuned. Your hair is on point, Zoe. On point. Welcome to episode 6 of the Unrated Cut. Last episode. I mean, thank you for watching, everyone that watched the trauma episode. Apologies for how graphic it got.
I think we just have to apologise for the entire episode, really.
Yeah. I mean, it was hard to kind of tackle that because it is such a boundary pushing film.
Yeah.
I think that's the only thing. I mean, honestly, give it a watch. Let us know your thoughts on it. I mean, I think we went a bit too far in that sometimes. But sometimes you have to talk about what is actually in it because it is the subject matter of the film. You know, this is an extreme horror show. Apologies if we did offend anyone, but you know, these things have to be said when you're talking about subject matter like that. So, apologies, but you know, I hope you enjoyed
Don't
it. If you
us.
Did, today we're going a bit of a tonal shift.
Thank
Not giving
fuck,
it away,
right?
But let's do this episode. So today we've got another competition we can talk about, which we'll do at the end.
Yes.
Which is super exciting.
We're just rolling
out swag.
We're just sending you shit for free because
you're welcome.
We're very generous.
I'm not going to do double guns again because I've done that. I think
because
at the end of every episode.
Like,
yeah, it is. Dad jokes. It's cool though. It's cool. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it, Dad.
This is life.
Okay.
So what are we talking about today?
So today we are talking about Ichi the Killer. It came up in the random generator. Exactly.
I just think I'm like, ooh, itchy. Ooh, I'm itchy. Feeling itchy. I've got eczema, so that's
great.
How I feel most days, to
great.
Be honest.
Revealed in episode 6, Zoe has skin conditions.
Got a little bit here, actually.
Excellent. Me too, I've got a little bit there. It's gone now. Is it gone? Is it literally gone?
I don't think that's eczema. That's
just,
dry
skin. You're welcome, everyone.
There's a difference.
Hi, Mom. Got dry skin. Cool. We've all had a drink.
Too many, it seems,
yeah,
right?
Apparently so.
Who chose this? Do we know?
Well, if you chose, I had a look through our list.
It got lost in the melee.
We had so many kind of come through at one point. For some reason, Ichi the Killer is one of the only ones that hasn't got a credited submitter.
It was probably me, and you asked me to find the name, and I probably just... I'm not going to lie, I don't really do things properly.
No.
Chris asked me to do stuff, and I go...
As we were aware.
Yeah, I'll do that
so
in the next
do this
2 minutes.
And, doesn't happen.
Chris prepares for
it's
our
fine.
Episodes, and I literally turn up and go... Well,
I've had three gins.
I'm fucked, so let's just roll with it.
And that's what we do. But it's all right, you know, you seem to like it, so whatever. But yeah, so if you did submit Ichi the Killer, please just leave your name in a comment below this video, and we'll give you full props.
Yeah.
Sorry if that's the case, but Ichi the Killer.
Thank you.
So yeah, we're going to talk about that in just a few seconds, but here is the trailer. I don't know why I'm doing this in French. But it is, the trailer is coming.
A woohoo.
Shall there.
Snails.
お前死刑だんだよ。絶対見つけるから。復讐できるんだ。
じゃあどうだ。あの、1。1ってやっぱ化け物みたいなやつですね。早くこいつに会いたいよ、俺。
Nope. No,
please
no,
don't.
No,
we all know you said it now.
No, 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 no. No, 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 no,
no, no, no, no,
no,
no, no, no, no, no, no,
no, no, no, no, no,
anyway, what we're doing? I don't think Chris should drink when I drink because...
No, it's a shit show.
You're drinking. Jen's not here to stop us.
No, she's not here to wind me in. So, Ichi the Killer, submitted by Anonymous. Zoe, what's Ichi about?
It's about a man with really bad eczema. Sorry. So, I'm going to refer to my notes for this one because this storyline just was all over the fucking place.
Slight little tease on Zoe's thoughts on this movie.
So, the Yakuza boss gets kidnapped by...
Anjo, I believe his name is.
Huh?
Anjo is the name of the Yakuza
boss.
That's
it. I thought it was Anas, but that's the pineapple... That's the Spanish spelling for pineapple, not anus. So...
Can I just get a little bit of anus?
Anus.
Okay, Karen, yep.
Anus.
Thanks, Lauren. Yeah, cool. Perfect.
So, the Yakuza boss gets kidnapped, and he has his, what, kind of like side man, called Kakihara, who is a torturer slash sadomasochist.
Yep.
Spelt that one out. Chris
but slight masochist as well. I mean, his whole thing is his like pain getting...
He likes pain. He likes sharing pain, giving pain. Mm-hmm. Pain is his name. Pain is his game.
Yes.
Bitches, please. Anyway, that's what he does. So he starts looking for the boss.
This is my life now. Karen.
Chris loves it. So this is... I was going to say, this is my life. This is not my life. I'm not in the Yakuza yet. So yeah, so he starts looking for the boss. And he comes across another guy called Ichi. Who doesn't have eczema as far as we know.
Nope.
And he's kind of this creepy, creepy, repressed.
Can we just keep beeping these in? repressed.
And he comes across Ichi, who is this creepy, repressed sexual man who's great at killing. Fuck this happened.
Who's
this
crazy repressed man who is good at killing? You're a reviewer. You're a writer.
I don't say words.
He is a man that mans.
Okay, rewind. Right,
rewind. Z. Okay.
He meets Ichi. He meets Ichi, who's a guy who is hired by Gigi.
Yes, correct, Gigi, yeah.
Who basically tipped off Kakihara as to who perhaps kidnapped...
his boss, yeah.
Anjo.
Yes.
The boss. And basically, he's very sexually repressed.
Indeed.
A sexual assault. He was bullied when he was younger, so he's gone through a lot of bad things. And he comes across as this very shy guy, but actually he's got an amazing talent for
killing
people.
Yes.
And the film is about kind of Kakihara and also Ichi and how they're going through the Yakuza in different ways. Kakihara trying to get to whoever stole the boss.
And the money, the 100 million
the money
or whatever
as well.
It was. Yeah.
And then also Ichi deciding that he wants to be the good guy and killing the whole Yakuza.
That's
and
it.
Ending up with a kind of face-off between the two of them.
That's right. I mean, that's pretty much sums it all up. I mean, it's a two-hour epic of a film.
It's actually over 2 hours.
It's two hours and 9 minutes. There you go.
Those 9 minutes.
You're welcome. So, all right. Well, let's. Okay. So, there's been some hints on people's opinions of this film. Zoe, do you like this movie?
No.
Okay.
That was quite easy for me to do. No.
Okay.
So, the amount of times that I've been recommended this movie is countless, and I've had it on my list for a very long time, and read the synopsis, and I was like, oh, it sounds pretty decent. Heard it was very gory. Heard it was quite extreme in terms of like torture, murder, slaughter, all of those things. So, I mean, why wouldn't it go on my list?
But yeah, right.
I think for me, it's not an extreme horror film. Okay. It's actually, and I mean, it's defined online as a crime mm-hmm. movie, which it is, because the Yakuza is a crime type thing. And,
yep.
and I understand with a lot of the kind of gangster things comes torture, mm-hmm. comes a lot of violence, which is absolutely fine. But Yakuza gangster is probably one of my least favorite genres.
Okay.
As like a, not a genre, but you know, kind of like a storyline. I just find it very repetitive. You know, if I watch a gangster film, it's like, the mob boss is not here. And then you've got like 20 fucking minions, and they're not yellow, and they don't have bananas, mm-hmm. which would make
Banana.
It way better, in my personal opinion. But it's fine.
Way better.
Way better, you know.
Put your curds and
like
whey
a pancake.
Yeah, exactly.
With your batter.
Yeah.
way better. Mm-hmm. But I don't know, it's just, it always seems like the same storyline
okay.
over and over again.
Okay.
And all right, to be fair to this film, storyline is kind of fucking here, there,
well,
and everywhere.
I think you're right, yeah. I mean,
a lot happens in this movie, and it's 2 hours and 9 minutes, like
yep.
you said, so you've got a lot of different things. But if you kind of break it down, nothing really happens.
Okay.
In my opinion.
Okay.
I think Chris.
You
disagrees.
For me. I'm not gonna say. Yeah. I'm not gonna say you couldn't be more wrong, because that's not the case. There's some things I agree with, but disclaimer. It's happened. Roles have been reversed. Zoe hates this film. I
didn't think this would happen.
I think I gave the game away when we drew this one out of the pot. I love this movie. The reason I love this movie is, I think, because you said this isn't an extreme horror film for me. I think this is a real life interpretation of a comic book / anime film / video game. I mean, the really interesting point that I actually wanted to talk about that you've touched on there is you say it's really repetitive, and it is. So Ichi are kind of, I say he's our hero, but I love the way he's damaged, which we'll go into in a minute. He's not. But it's almost like a video game in terms of, it's like playing Street Fighter, because it's repetitive, because he is basically sent out to pick off these Yakuza bosses one by one by his handler, Gigi, who is almost like the Kaiser Sose of this film, because he's kind of portrayed at the beginning as this kind of weird dude that has nothing to do, and everyone kind of brings him down, but spoiler alert, he turns out to be in one of my favourite things, of he takes his jacket off and he's this hench little dude,
hench.
He comes out. It's just, I mean, again, sorry for the spoiler
and
there.
He has
not
cute
seen it.
Son.
He does have a cute son.
And he seems like at the beginning he seems like an arsehole.
He
dad.
Does.
Yeah, no.
But
yeah,
it plays out like a video game, because he's sent
he
out
does.
To pick off all these people, and Ichi basically comes in and sort of levels up every time. It's like, you know, round one, you're done. And then he moves up to the next one. But the thing I love about this movie, and it's not, I don't love everything about it, but the thing I absolutely love about it is its charm. I mean, honestly, Takashi Miike is, I think, one of the most interesting directors there is. And he plays this off. I mean, there's this spate, particularly from Disney now, of these kind of real life adaptations of animated films.
Mm-hmm.
This is 100% an adaptation of a manga / anime film.
Yeah.
And you see it in his cinematography. There are lingering scenes, and Ichi himself, I mean, despite his character flaws again, which we'll get into in a second, his expression is cartoonish. I mean, it's all attempts to do it, you know, he smiles and he's happy. It's, I mean, it is, to an extent, it is just, it's phenomenal. I mean,
and perhaps that's what I didn't like about it, because anyone that knows me knows I really don't like anime and mm-hmm. I don't like manga, unless it's One Punch Man, which is, except for the recent series, because that was fucking atrocious. But the first series was amazing.
Yeah.
You know, One Punch!
One Punch Man!
That
I've
was
never
great.
Seen the show, but I'll sing a theme tune for it, One Punch Man.
That's not
You're
the
welcome.
Theme tune.
Cool.
It's like a, yeah. Anyway, typically I'm really not into the manga
yep.
anime thing.
Neither am I, disclaimer, either. But there's such
but
a reference
I
point.
But I can see, when I watch the film, I can see it, you know, like I think one for me was the opening scene, is how it's shot in a very particular way. It kind of darts across
very
and then it's slow and then it darts across.
Super quick.
And I really enjoyed that, but that's particularly where I could see the anime aspects of it. And then, like you said, with the facial expressions, they're very animated. You know, he's kind of like... And I think when you're acting in a movie, that comes across as overacted, where you kind of
Yes, it is, but like, there's the point behind it.
And then he's like, oh, I'm going to cry. And I'm looking at him like, what the fuck is
that's the point.
Wrong with
that
you,
is absolutely the point. But that's, that's what he's tried, that's what Mika's tried to create.
And which I think is, you know, in that terms, I have to give it a lot of merit for, because, you know, that's hard to do, is to translate manga, anime into film.
Yes.
But if you're not into manga anime, and also I didn't know this was an adaptation, so if I don't know and I'm not into it and then I see that on screen, to me it just looks like awful acting. I'm like, why the fuck is he making that fucking stupid face?
Yeah, and there was,
and he's like, oh, I'm happy, and I'm like, are you fucking
I didn't know it was an adaptation
idiot.
Either, like, but it's you can kind of tell, just like I said, through the way that it's acted out. I mean, the thing that I love about it, again, is it's got this kind of... And this is actually almost one of its flaws as well. There are so many people in this movie that it's actually quite hard to keep up with who's coming in. But there are all your typical kind of... The actors portray these kind of the stereotypical anime characters.
I mean,
like the deep-voiced, I am big henchman man and I have a deep voice. Everyone, there's like a kind of your typical kind of anime characters portrayed to a T.
In the first 15 minutes, you're like, all right, I know Kakihara, I know Ichi, I know. And then you're suddenly like, why is there 30 fucking men that all have a line to say?
Because they're all Yakuza.
And you're like, yeah, and I'm like, right, so that's John and that's Peter and that's, who the fuck is that again? And he's like, well, I'm going to fucking kick the shit out of this prostitute. And I'm like, what? Was he part of the Yakuza? Or is he the good guy? Or is he a bad guy? I mean, he seems like a bad guy.
Yeah, it's tough.
Kick the shit out of a woman.
It's tough
but
to
then
kind of
I'm
keep
like,
up.
I don't really understand. And then there's a guy masturbating outside. And then there's another guy there. And I'm like, so who was that again? And then Kakihara comes back. And I'm like, right, that's Ichi the Killer. And they go, well, no, that's not Ichi the Killer. And Ichi the Killer's in the corner. I was like,
right.
So is he pretending to be the other guy? And I'm just sat there and I'm going,
It's tricky, isn't it?
I'm not entirely sure what the fuck is
going
on right now.
I can, I mean, if I'm going to label one criticism on this film, that is, well, actually two criticisms, that it's really long. But that is definitely one of it. It's quite hard to keep up with. But for me, I think the weirdest thing about this film is, like you said, it's portrayed, and it has been portrayed for a long time, as a very extreme piece of cinema. But the fact, the way it's made, like I said, in this kind of animated way, there's some really brutal assaults on women in here. And normally, how many times have I said it? One of the things I really hate about extreme cinema is unnecessary sex scenes, unnecessary rape scenes, any sort of assault scene I really struggle with. This, there are some sexual assault scenes, but it kind of, and I know this is going to sound horrible and desensitized, they kind of bounce off because the way it's sort of done, I mean, it's not making light of these scenes, but it's, you see what I mean, right? I mean, they're
I actually felt with the gratuitous violence against women in this, I felt the opposite. I mean, we've obviously watched the film in this show, and we've watched a lot of other ones, and I think this film, for me, I felt like the entire tone of the film is so comedic that when you get to the violence against women, it has a comedic element to it.
Okay. Does that, and that makes that worse for you?
It made it, so there's the part, I mean, there's one particular girl that's beaten very badly at the beginning. I mean, very, very badly. And I was like, and then they go immediately from that into the jizz title screen, which feels very
funny.
Which
I want to talk about a little bit.
But it feels very funny, that, and I'm like, but that funny title scene comes from something so fucking horrible.
Yes, I agree.
That for me, I was like,
I agree.
The tone there is completely off.
I think I agree that it's bold to do that because it happens. So the sexual assault scene happens. It's the first thing you see in the film. And then, as Zoe says, the titles are spawned from a pool of ejaculate that our voyeur has left while watching this assault. But it's actually an introduction to Ichi. So to touch on Ichi for a minute, our hero, as it were, Ichi has an issue in terms of, Ichi was subjected to watching a sexual assault when he was a young boy, and he saw this girl getting raped by some classmates, and he didn't do anything about it. But what Ichi's been living with, he doesn't feel guilty about not stepping in. He feels guilty because he liked watching it. So Ichi is almost a kind of a sadomasochist in terms of he likes inflicting pain. And what happens in this story is it plays out that he is a sadomasochist and he gets off on inflicting pain on others. And I think, and that's the really interesting thing about this movie is because Ichi is played as this really innocent kind of damaged kid, because he's supposed to be pretty young.
He is. He can't. And, yeah, he's very young, and he is kind of damaged. But like,
but no, but that's the that's the interesting thing for me, because it's played out. You don't feel sympathy for him because actually he's a fucking nasty bastard inside.
He gets all of them are.
Yeah, they are.
But then again, Kakihara, well, he is nasty, but he's also, I mean, he's portrayed as, you know, he's the torturer and he does all these things, but he doesn't seem as bad.
All right, okay, that's a good...
As Ichi does.
It's a good segue. Let's talk about Kakihara, because he's the villain of the piece. I think he is one of the best bad guys that I have seen in ages.
100%.
And to an extent where it's not Ichi's face on the cover of the DVD.
No, it not
is,
at all.
It's Kakihara that is almost the sell point of this film. And he has... So his image, and my favorite, one of my favorite things about this film is the introduction to Kakihara. So he has some scarring on the side of his face. So at one point, I mean, it's very quickly it's very quickly spelled out.
I have to pause here. I'm going to pee myself.
Okay, Zoe's going to pee herself. So Kakihara, like I said, is, for me, pound for pound, one of the best villains. But the thing I really like about it, like I said, is the introduction where he comes in. He's got these, so it's portrayed that he is a masochist, so he likes having pain inflicted on him.
Yeah.
And he has all reams of scars, but the most telling ones, which leads to my favourite point in the entire film, he has these slits up his face, which he holds together. Yeah, a bit like the Joker. Which he holds together with these, they're kind of like earrings that sort of hold them together. But the first thing you see, he walks in, he's smoking a cigarette, and he takes a puff out, but rather than coming out of his mouth, it comes out the sides of his cheeks.
I mean,
and it's one of the best things. But
and I do think, you know, even though I'm saying I don't like the film, I think as a villain, he's fucking awesome.
He is fantastic.
He's got an aesthetic where if he came in, you go,
he does,
and he's maybe going to fuck me up a little bit.
Exactly, he steals the show, which is why I think he almost deserves his place on the DVD cover. But the thing as well that I love about him is there is a real synergy between him and Ichi, because they're almost like they're made to be together. Because Kakihara is a pure masochist, Ichi is a sadomasochist,
and it's played out exactly. Can you imagine if they were like a Yakuza force that went around torturing and murdering.
Oh, okay, yep, yeah, sure. Well, I mean, okay. They will probably
Chris
do that.
Got a little,
well, they would, because I mean,
I was,
you know,
say,
they
just like power. Well,
but
it's
not. But
together,
I think I actually think that is subtext there, because one of the things. So, Kakihara, he starts a relationship with this chick, inexplicably called Karen.
Oh,
which is an odd thing.
Karen,
stupid Karen. I mean,
why? Can I just ask? That's the thing. That was one thing that really fucking pissed me off. You have this entire film, very genuine in terms of names. And then fucking Karen turns up.
Karen!
And also, she's fucking annoying. Why don't she speaks English for a bit?
I love that. I love that, because it's so nonsensical. Because it's completely nonsensical and it kind of just takes you out of it again.
She's like talking about, and she's like, and then my dog had a German Shepherd. And I'm like,
your dog had a German Shepherd?
Oh yeah, neighbor.
Dog porn.
My dog had a German Shepherd, and my dog loved German Shepherd, and he was just a little pooch.
Yeah, so it all gets weird, but I mean, it's
it's
really interesting, and the dynamic there is really interesting, and that's kind of played out throughout the whole thing. Because the first thing you see when Kakihara starts his relationship with Karen is he gets really pissed off and dumps her because she can't beat him up enough, and the only person, and this is played out at the end, person that can come close to giving Kakihara what he wants masochistically
is Ichi.
And I love that, and I love the way that plays out.
But the problem with Ichi, he's fucking lame. He's like, he cries all the time. He's like, I want to kill this guy for you because I love you.
But then again, the darkness of Ichi plays out quite nicely there. For the second time today.
What you say? You only meant well,
but I'll cope through. I mean, if this is where this needs to be a podcast, because I could just wax here. But that's where it plays out so nicely for me, because there's a great synergy there between Kekuhara and Ichi. But Ichi's so damaged, and that you do get that stupid kind of, you know. But then that brings out the best sort of one-liners. This is the weirdest thing I've ever done.
And Chris comes in, I'm just reassessing.
Exactly, reassessing
my
life.
Ichi.
You're itchy.
Itchy microphone.
If we could get back to the point, Smithers, it's, you know, he plays out this kind of real damaged way, and he thinks that he's a hero to this woman that gets beaten up at the beginning, because he's like, now I can beat you in the way you wanted to, which is a lie.
Actually, on that point, Chris, because I got really confused. There was many points in the film where I was like, I honestly have no fucking idea what the fuck is going on. Who the fuck is that? What the fuck is this? I don't know what the fuck this film is, but that's fine. That's the thing, is it's very obvious that it's Takeshi Mike.
Yeah.
Because he makes films where you watch it and you just go, I don't know what the fuck is going on. And that's this film, which is why I immediately was like, yep, that's him, because what the fuck?
Yeah, he does.
And I love a film where I just go, I've got no fucking idea. But why? I've lost my point that I was going to ask. But why? What were we just talking about?
Why does he feel like he needs to beat her up?
Why is he feeling like he can't sleep? Like, why is that whole section where she gets beat up and everything, and then she meets him, and then she goes to his, and he's like, oh, I realise. She wants to get raped because she doesn't want to get raped, so she wants to get raped.
Because he gets
hit
wrong.
And then he kills the guy, and he's like, oh, I understand. You actually, I'll beat you up now.
Yeah, because he gets it wrong. He is damaged. He doesn't know himself. He doesn't know the world. And that's almost his charm. I mean, I'm not saying he's charming. I know.
But this is what I'm saying. You don't like getting beat up by the other guy? Well, I'll kill him. And then he goes, but I'll beat you up. And she's I just want to go for dinner and drinks. And he goes, no, I'll beat the shit out of you instead.
Because he doesn't know what's going on.
And she's literally laying there like, I fucking hate my life. And he's like, I'm a hero. And I'm watching, I'm going, you're a fucking idiot.
Yeah,
mate.
No, he is, but that's the point.
And I just watch it.
That's the point!
Yeah, but it pisses me off.
How have you missed the point so spectacularly?
No, I see the point. I just fucking hate him. I hate him. I like Kekuhara, but Kekuhara is the
man. Yes! Kekuhara is the man. We're all a little bit in love with Kekuhara.
I don't like him either.
Can we talk about the best scene in the film? Which is where Kekuhara with his... I mean, Takeshi Miike has nailed so many scenes in this film. The scene there is a fight between a minor Yakuza man and Kekuhara. And Kekuhara takes out his rings between his mouth.
Yeah, that's true.
And man punches him in the mouth. And he absorbs his fist
and
in his mouth.
And you like that
scene? Yes, it's amazing, because it means nothing and it's not weird and it's not rapey like what you like in your weird
trauma films. No, because it's just he's going like...
Yeah, I know, but it's cool. Like, and it was made in... When was this made? It was 2001, wasn't it? Great special effects. The thing again, so this this is a good point to talk about it, because Takeshi Miike, he can make a film like this, but also he can make something as wild as insane as this film, but he can also then go and make something as dark and as terrifying as Audition. And that for me just highlights what a talented director he is, because he can flip between the absolute ridiculousness of Ichi. Because it's a comic book. I mean, the violence, we've spoken about it. It's extreme, there's blood. It's very Kill Bill in like that it's played out as a comic book, and it's too extreme, it's over the top.
As a comic book, don't make it into a fucking weird ass film.
Can everyone, I think, yeah, I know, but I feel like we're at a kind of an apex with this. I think everyone should let us know, are you Team Ichi or are you Team Scratchy? I don't know. But it's, I mean, I can't understand. I mean, that you find the stuff that you like is so visceral that you watch this and you won't appreciate it because it's light.
Dumb. I mean, it's made by, like, you know, a fucking teenager who's like, oh, funny. if the fist goes in his mouth and he's like, and
so what you're saying, like, it's like, this is the best Beavis and Butthead impression I've ever seen in like, honestly, 20 years.
Got it fishy, mommy. And then I was like, all right. And then the end is just,
the end is played out. Now, one of the criticisms, the major criticism I have is this film does go on too long. It's probably about half an hour too long. It could have been played out quicker.
It could have been 30 minutes.
In terms of extreme cinema, this is one of the nicest watches you'll have. It's insane. It's lighthearted. I stamp my fist on Ichi. I like it. So deal with it.
So what are you going to give it? The rating?
I will knock a point off because it goes on a bit too long, and I agree, I can't quite get behind Ichi because he's a weird chap and there's some terrible stuff. Don't like Karen, like you say. We haven't even spoken about the little two clean-up dudes that turn up and just clean up crime scenes in their kind of the best way. But we're going on too long anyway. But I will give Ichi 4 out of 5. Love it. Zoe, what would you give it? Come on. Come on in.
At a stretch, and this is me being nice, because I liked the gore. The gore was good.
The gore is great.
And also because it's got some decent bits. I'm going to give it a 2, which for me is pretty harsh. But 2 out of 5 because...
What did you give Trauma?
3.5.
You're a fucking monster.
Incest over Yakuza any day.
Incest or wincest, I suppose, is the...
Winning on incest. Fuck your cousin. Do it.
Okay.
It's not
and
legal.
On that note, we're going to come back in just a few minutes with a new way that we're going to pick the next film to watch in episode 7. We're going to make things a little bit different and details of the competition coming your way right now. Okay, so let's finish glugging. She's finished glugging. So let's talk about this competition. So it's been running for a little while. You've probably seen it on our socials already. But check it out again because this ends tomorrow. So this is the competition to win the incredible Antichrist soundtrack. It was released on Friday the 6th of September through Cold Spring Records, and it is a piece of fucking art as well as being a soundtrack. So you want to get on that. So the kicker thing that you need to know is the competition ends tomorrow. So check our socials. You'll see it on there. Get involved. Follow the instructions. Be in a chance to win it because it is incredible.
And I think the key takeaway is if no one wins, I'm fucking having it.
Don't do that because I'm not allowed to do that because I promised it to other people who have already entered the competition.
I'm the winner. That's it. No, that's not true. Okay. I'm not.
All right, so this is normally about the time in the show where we draw and suggest or pick a film that we're going to watch in the next episode, episode 7. But we're going to change tact a little bit. We're going to get you involved again. Dun, 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 dun.
Dun, dun, dun.
We're going to get you involved again. However, we've picked 3 out of the list that we think... It would be kind of fun to discuss. So
actually, there's a couple.
No, I don't want to watch. I've seen a couple of these, and I don't want to watch them again.
We've been fair.
We have been fair.
What we don't want to watch, what we might want to watch, what we kind of want to watch.
Yeah, what we would watch again. Exactly. But the difference is, so we're going to name 3 films that we picked out of the list. You guys are going to vote for them. So you can go to our Twitter, just shout the name. You can go comments below this video.
We want videos.
Shout, we want videos. Yeah, let's do that as well.
Yeah.
Scream the name of the film. So Zoe, what are the 3 films that people can choose from? And they are treats. Film number 1.
Film number 1 is a film about eating shit.
Yeah.
What movie? It is, of course, it is Salo, aka 120 Days of Sodom. Because who doesn't want 120 Days of Sodom, right? Kinky as fuck.
KAF. Number 2.
Second film is, oh my god, cute one.
Is Professionals.
We've got a sun. It's not the Teletubbies. It's Men Behind the Sun.
Dun, 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 dun.
And then the third film is one that actually, I have a feeling we might both potentially agree on it if we cover it, which we probably won't.
No, you've ruined it. No one's going to pick it now, are they?
Oh, for fuck's sake. Well,
don't think, do you? Just don't think. Doesn't plug a mic in, doesn't think. But go on, film number 3.
I hate life. Anyway, film number 3 is Visitor Q.
Dun, 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 dun. Following on from, I had a bit of a expression about how much I love Japanese extreme cinema.
Thought you were going to say how much you love breast milk.
If you've seen Visitor Q, you get it. If not, I look like a weird sex man. So...
Weird sex man!
That's
me!
Worst thing ever! I am.
You're itchy.
Itchy the weird sex man.
You're itchy, I'm scratchy. Wait, okay. Is that The Simpsons?
Yes, it is, yeah. Cool.
No copyright.
No, please, yeah. Yeah, let's not go there.
Anyway,
that's good. So there's your three. So you've got Salo, you've got Visitor Q, you've got Men Behind the Sun. Vote now. We'll pick a winner in the next sort of few days, I reckon, just before we film episode number 7. And oh my goodness, what a time to be alive. So I think we're going to call it a day there.
Yeah,
you hate Ichi. I love Ichi. Everyone loves Ichi.
I am
Please
scratchy.
Tell me you all love Ichi. We'll see you for episode 7 very soon. Bye-bye.